This is Sub-Zero, back with another video just for all of you guys. And man, I am so excited to finally bring this special video that I've been working quite a while on. And this is my 1 year review of owning my 2019 Chevy Corvette C7 Z06 with a Z07 package. This is exactly how the car is looking currently up to date. Man, where to start? Thank you guys for watching the intro. If you skipped ahead, no worries at all. Like I said, I put it at the beginning, so that way you guys don't have to worry about the intro. You can get right into the meat and bones of exactly how this review is going to be. But I really want to start off by just saying thank you guys for clicking this video. I appreciate all of you guys. We're at 20,500 subscribers. That's so big to me. That's so huge. I didn't even think I'd get here. I just want to keep making content that you guys all appreciate, all of you guys like. If you're new to the channel, make sure you guys hit the subscribe button. Go ahead and check out some of my old content as far as my Corvette. I also had a C6 Corvette or any of my Subaru content. But anyway, guys, like I said, this is my Corvette. And right off the bat, the most important thing to me when it comes to a car is feel, drivability, and just that it factor, that fun factor, and that engaging factor. And this car truly, in so many ways, just gives that to you. You know, I want to take you guys on a ride with me for this video instead of just seeing me walking around the car, just talking about it. I want you guys to have some nice cinematography, some nice visuals, and to really get a feel of how it looks in the cockpit. Now, the first thing that I recommend as far as the mods for this car is the MGW shifter. If you have a manual, as far as this video goes, I'm taking this all in one take. So I really just want to give you guys my authentic, off the top of the mind, just off the top of the head, exactly how I feel about the car. But other than the MGW shifter, the DSC controller and DSC tractive shocks is the most important modification that anyone can do to this car, whether you're road coursing it, whether you're just driving on the street, whether you're driving in the canyons, whether you're tracking it, whether you're dragging it. That controller and those tractive shocks completely changes the suspension dynamics, makes it adaptive, active suspension. It really just transforms this car into a vehicle that feels stable. You know, I feel very comfortable. I have a lot of confidence in the car. You know, I've seen a lot of reviews where people would say the car is, the tail gets out of them, or it just wants to break loose. It doesn't feel stable. It doesn't feel like it's controlled. It kind of feels like a wild bull where you have no idea when the traction can just lose on you. But having that controller and having those shocks truly makes this just a smooth car, but a very just overall engaging and confidence-inspiring car. You know, I've driven many cars. I've driven the Audi R8s. I've driven the Maserati Gran Turismos. I've driven lots of exotic-type cars, but those tractive shocks and that suspension and the other parts, you know, the LG sway bars, you know, all the other suspension pieces I did to this car, I have to say, this might be the best just suspension felt car that I've been in personally. Especially when it comes to manual cars. Now, one of the biggest things I know a lot of people research when it comes to these cars is, does it overheat? You know, is there an overheating factor? Do you lose power? Do you go into limp mode? You know, what happens? Have you gone to that in any of the track sessions you've been on? You know, I want to let you guys know, I haven't had a single issue with any cooling. I do have a custom Ron Davis radiator, and I know these 19s have some more updates to them. The 17s upgrade the auxiliary radiators as well, and I do have a lot of ventilation. I think that's also one of the big things. So I do have the competition carbon hood. I do have some extra vents on the side. I have my fender vents on the side as well. So a lot of the heat that comes in these cars from factory and stock, there aren't that much airflow that can escape. So I really do think all that pent-up heat that just sits in the car is also a big reason why this car is overheat. But I haven't had any issues when it comes to overheating the car. You know, I've been to Big Willow. Like I said, I live in Los Angeles, California. It's been hot. It's been 90 degrees. It's been 100 degrees. I haven't been in the limp mode yet. I do a good job of regulating how much, you know, I push my laps, but I've done 10, 11, 12, 13 laps in a row in one session, you know, 30 minute, sometimes 45 minute sessions. And I have not had any limp mode issues at all. I know a lot more of the automatics have that, but my car has not had that issue at all. Now, as far as reviewing the power, this car, personally, the way it comes from factory feels perfect in terms of how much power you get. But I will say, on the stock tune, it does kind of feel a little laggish. You know, I guess coming from so many tuned cars and so many cars that have a bunch of modifications to them, you can really feel the difference between just the throttle and the response, the instantaneousness. When it comes to just acceleration, when it comes to just front forks, when it comes to just getting out the gate, when it comes to just, you know, downshifting and punching the gas, just even the throttle feel. I noticed that there is a slight delay sometimes, not in like a bad way, but it just doesn't feel fully like the tune is fully there. And again, I'm being very, very nitpicky, mainly because I am very used to tuned cars. But if there was one thing that this car will definitely you can improve upon while doing some modifications, would be that. I do plan on doing, you know, the Kong ported blower, 103 throttle body, and doing a tune and doing some other things that will definitely reduce that and actually make that a non-issue, a non-factor moving forward. But definitely, if I had to say there was one thing that is the slightest, would just be that subtle throttle kind of lagginess. But again, that's very nitpicky. But one of the biggest factors and one of the coolest things with this C7 Z06 that the other Corvette Z06s, especially the manuals, and a lot of cars for that matter, don't have, is the active rev match. And oh my gosh, every manual car should have a rev match feature automatically. With the technology, you know, some cars have them. I know the Nismos are one of the first ones that have them. A few other companies of cars have them. Some exotics have them. And now the Z06 has it. And when you guys have this, it just makes downshifting, shifting, just everything about it feel so much better. You know, coming from Subarus, I know how to heel toe, how to blip throttle, how to perfectly match. Subarus can be very twitchy when it comes to shifting, but overall, when it comes to these cars, just having the active rev match just changes that dynamic so much. Basically, all your downshifts are basically 100%. So when you're on the track, or when you're on the street, whatever it is, bam, you downshift, it is perfect every single time. And that just reduces your track times, or reduces just all of that delay. It reduces the jerkiness of the car. You can turn it off, so if you do want to go back to just kind of revving it yourself, rev matching yourself, the plus and the minus in these manual cars, if you actually see it says rev match, that's actually how you turn it on and off. So you can turn it off, but personally, in my opinion, this is one of those things, if I get another manual car down the road that doesn't have active rev match, you know, I'm looking for ways to get that in my Subaru. You know, once you have it, it's just one of those things that you just cannot have in a car again. But overall, just my review of having this car for a year, this has been my dream car. I've been working so hard for many years. When I first saw this car released in 2014 and then 2015, you know, I fell in love with this car. I've always been a fan of Corvettes, but I told myself one day I would have this exact car. I would build it, I would track it, I would truly build it the right way. I would just be patient with it. I would just really buy the best of the best of the things when it comes to this car. And overall, this car has been far, far superior than any of my expectations I ever thought that I could have in a car. When everyone says, you know, when you get a Corvette, you're gonna end up just staying with Corvette, it is true. You know, I've had multiple Corvettes now, and this by far has been the best feeling Corvette I've ever been in, and honestly, the best manual car I've ever been in. Like I said, I love to track cars, I love to be in mini cars, but this car, just something about it that really just connects you to the car. It makes you really feel confident, but it really just gives you that feel, that it factor that's a lot of cars are really missing these days. It really truly gives you that special it factor. But overall, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed just me reviewing this car. I hope you enjoyed some of the video. Those are my buddies, some of my closest friends. I let them drive the car. I let them review the car as well. You guys can check out my channel. There's two videos talking about their review of the vehicle. But now that I've had it for a year now, I've done quite a bit of work on it. I have a lot of work to go on the car. But that's just from living with it, from driving it, from having it every single day. You can take this on a back road. You can take this on the street. You can take it on a highway. You can cruise in it. Gets great gas mileage. You know, when I'm cruising on the highway, I'm going like 70, 75. I'm getting like high 20s, low 30 miles per gallon on the freeway. Like, it's pretty insane how good of gas this car can get with how powerful and how fast it is. It's a very nimble car. And Chevy, you guys are just hit out the ballpark with this one. I know a lot of people are really excited. The new C8 Z06 just got revealed. And oh my gosh, that flat plane crank, that 5.5 liter, 670 naturally aspirated, 670 horsepower engine, man. It's insane what Chevy is doing. But I really have to say, this is the king of manuals. This car, if you guys are interested in buying this car, definitely go and get one. I highly recommend it. This has been the most fun car I've ever been in. You will not ever feel any different if you go for the manual. I can't say the same for the auto. I don't have as much experience in the automatics, but the manual of this car, and if you guys do the right mods to this car, if you build it the right way, you will absolutely love this car. You will enjoy this car, and you will truly feel how amazing this car is. Anyway, I hope you guys like the video. Hit the like button. If you guys like the video, hit the subscribe button. Follow the journey. And like I always keep saying, guys, go after dreams and make them reality. And the world needs more heroes, and we all have the power to be a hero, y'all. I just want to keep saying, man, I'm so humble. I'm so blessed. I'm so blessed to have you guys on this journey with me. Like I said, 20,500 subscribers. I'm really sorry for the lack of videos lately. I've just been so busy with work, investing, DJing, my consulting jobs. I do a whole bunch of stuff that I know one of these videos I'm gonna have to go over, because I know a lot of you guys ask what I do to be able to afford and pay for all the things I do. I'm paying for all the mods, paying for all my cars, and just overall, just all that type of stuff and information. Anyway, be safe, y'all. Peace.